So we were just talking about this space that we're in. Talk about you finding the place that you were going to shoot.
So, I mean, I always like to try and whenever possible to do things authentically from the start. I think anything that you can shoot for real and be in an environment, everything kind of bleeds through into the final picture, you know, you're watching, because when it's on that big screen, you know, all the details come through. So, you know, the film's set in Romania, and it was actually really a blessing to be able to go to Romania and film a classic horror movie in an actual castle in Transylvania. I mean, when did you get the chance to do that as a fan of horror? It was sort of a dream come true, and you know, for me, I love textures and you know, rich contrasts and shadows, and you know, when you go to an ancient castle or a convent, crumbling fortress, it's all there, and you just obviously switch the lights on a certain way and have a good DP and set design, and we would embellish that and bring art direction into it and create the sets as well in the studio. So. Yeah. Trying to create, I think, an environment that just feels deep.
Yeah, and the one that you chose, like how, or did you use amalgamation of different ones, or?
Yeah, I mean, it was very tricky. When you read the script, you know, you read a script, you're plowing through scenes, and it says that she walks through the dining hall, she turns, goes down a spiral staircase into a church and then a courtyard. You think, great, but then when you've actually got to find a place that you can shoot that geographically, it was quite a challenge. So I did a lot of planning, and we did a lot of scouting, and we sort of figured out this puzzle of where we could shoot in the main castle, which is Corvin Castle in Hunedoara, up in Transylvania. And then we also shot in a place called Criș and Sighișoara, and then we came down to Bucharest and shot the rest in the studio there. We built the tomb room and the church, and hopefully you can't tell which is real and which isn't.
And some of the other Conjurings kind of had a priest there on set. Did you guys do that? Or?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And it's just what New Line do with all their, you know, these horror movies in the Conjuring universe that have a religious aspect. They take it seriously, and they had a Catholic priest come and bless the set. And it took a long time. It was like a proper half an hour. I thought at first, oh, this is a bit of fun. But no, it was pretty serious. And he read out a lot of texts, and he had, I should know the names of these things, but he had this sort of smoke, and then he had a big bottle of holy water that he was blessing with a brush. And I was kind of curious, and he flung a big globule of holy water, and it got me right in the eye. So I felt particularly protected.
Well, has this experience kind of like, you know, it's all about the supernatural and good versus evil. Has it made you think about, you know, elements of faith and stuff like that?
I mean, for sure, when considering taking this on, and you know, and whilst creating it, wanting to make sure we respect it, and you know, we're obviously playing with a fantastical movie, but it's, you know, has religious connections and ideas and a lot of themes, you know, and I think just straight from the start, having an evil entity that is effectively disguising itself in the guise of something that's holy and good is what captured the audiences at The Conjuring 2, and what was exciting to be able to take that on and tell a story of where that came from and how this demon called Valak has come into our world.
Yeah, and you know, a lot of the faith audience, and there's probably like, you know, I'm a faith outlet and there's a bunch of other faith outlets here. What would you hope that, you know, faith audiences get out of this movie?
I hope that they feel that we've respected the subject matter. And hope that I'd love to think that they would also really enjoy the movie and get a thrill out of something which, you know, is in the playground of what their beliefs are, but also isn't offending anyone.
Yeah.
You know, it's ultimately, like a lot of movies, good versus evil. Exactly. And I don't want to spoil the movie, yeah. But, you know, there's a certain positivity to the outcome.
Oh, for sure, yeah. And how is it getting into the Conjuring world? Because this is really...
You know, a dream come true. You know, just the fact that there is a Conjuring world is pretty cool. You know, in this day and age, and you've got, you know, only certain movies coming out of the cinema and a lot coming out onto digital platforms. It's great, but, you know, I'm a guy who grew up ritualistically going to the cinema and taking friends and loving horror movies, and it's quite rare to get to go and see a horror movie at the cinema. And they are actually, I think, a really kind of group experience that you get a lot out of. People, you know, you can feel the sort of electricity when people get scared or laugh together and come together. So I think it's a, you know, I'd hope that people go as a group, and they go and see it and they get a bit of a thrill, they come out and survive it, you know.